seen Heather for a while.
Oh my god, he is.
I know.
You do? Alright, Twitter. How many of you have Twitter accounts?
Well, I created one specifically for this.
Alright, how many of you use Twitter often?
I used to.
Okay. What do you use it for?
Just mostly following, like, YouTubers and...
Okay.
Celebrities, pretty much.
More of a following than a posting. You too?
Yeah.
How about you? Same thing? So, Twitter's kind of different in that you don't have to be friends with the people to follow them or see what's going on, right? You have to follow them, but they don't have to accept you or approve you. It's not that two-way street that Facebook is. Yeah, it's not like real life at all. You want to be friends with the celebrity, you just go ahead and click and follow, and whatever they post, they're willingly posting to the free world, whoever wants to follow them. So, using Twitter for business, you think it's a good idea? Should companies, brands be on Twitter? Yep. Why? Any gut reactions as to why?
The amount of people you can reach.
Exactly. The amount of people you can reach is ginormous because, again, you don't have to approve them or actively go out and get them. They just follow you. Do any of you use Twitter for customer service purposes or when you've had a bad experience at something? Do you go to Twitter and call them out? You guys are the exception to the rule then, because that's what a lot of people do. If they've had a bad experience, they go straight to Twitter and they say, you know, thanks at Starbucks for burning my mouth with your $7 drink or something like that. It's a way to get the company's attention quickly. Paul Hoffman, who teaches in teaches marketing too, but back in the corner there, software, web developer, sorry, I'm losing my brain. He was trying to get some appointments with whatever dish service he has. I forget what it is, right? He was telling that story in Integrated, I think. And he, called, made appointments, called. Finally, he went to Twitter and called him out on there, and he got instant feedback. What can we do? We'll be there, you know, that's how we got their attention. So big brands have somebody monitoring social media and Twitter all the time. And it's a real-time exchange, and they do get back to you quite quickly. So it's a really smart way for engaging with your customers and hearing what's going on in the world. So how you can use Twitter, discover what's happening right now. This gives you access to what's in your industry, your community, and the world. So whatever's trending on Twitter is like the hot news right now, whether you agree with it or not. It could be some Kardashian nonsense, or it could be, you know, something current in the news with, you know, horrible shootings and things going on. So it's what's happening right now. You can grow your brand awareness. You can use ads there. Timely customer service. So people talk about the products they use on Twitter, and they expect to kind of get some feedback or results right away. 85% of small and medium business Twitter users say that it's important that they provide customer support on Twitter. So who would have thought? Instead of having somebody maybe answering the phone, you also have to have somebody dedicated to watching social media and Twitter. Connect with potential customers, brand advocates, and influencers. So influencer is a big buzzword right now. Any of you follow people like on YouTube that are influencers, that are famous because they made a YouTube video or something, right? How on earth did that ever happen, right? Isn't that crazy? Somebody is maybe sitting in their basement doing makeup tutorials, and all of a sudden they are very popular, very well known, and a company is paying them to promote things. So this is a way to connect with maybe your super fans that can be those people. Okay, so the anatomy of a tweet. Who has never been on Twitter and has no clue what this nonsense is? Okay? Kind of feel your pain. Like, I go on it, I look around, but I don't... Some people are actually afraid of Twitter because they don't understand what all these things are, how you do it. I don't get how I post something, right? So this is what a tweet looks like. Right, so this is the whole thing. This is called a tweet. And even though it's called Twitter, you don't make a twit, you make a tweet. So, yeah. This number two, the back arrow here, what do you think that does?
Reply.
Good guess, right? Reply? Yeah, absolutely. That's the reply button. So the reply, if you click on that, you respond to a tweet, and it shows that you're listening and engaged if you actually reply to something. The next one over is this round or square arrow that's like going in an infinite loop. That's retweet, okay? So retweeting shares someone else's tweet with the people who follow you. So Kim Kardashian tweets something, you think it's the best thing since sliced bread, you hit retweet, it goes out to your followers. You shared her content, basically. If you click the retweet button twice, you share the tweet as it is. Click, click. If you click once, you can add a comment, which is called quoting a tweet. So click once and say, oh, my best friend Kim said this. Isn't she funny? And you share her tweet. So that's tweeting and retweeting. If we go back to this thing, a heart, you can kind of guess what that's going to be like. That's a like it is in other social media, or the thumbs up or something. So why would companies like it if they get a bunch of hearts?
People like it.
People like it.
People like it. They're reacting to it. It was meaningful enough that people took the time to click like, not just read it and move on.
There's a demand for it.
There's a demand, yeah. So a simple way to positively acknowledge a tweet, it can be useful as a bookmarking tool if you want to easily find that tweet again. You can go and look at all of your liked tweets. The author will see that you appreciate it. All right, hashtags. Whoops. So in the tweet, they said, people on @Twitter love to see promotion tips, news, and behind-the-scenes looks. Test to see what your audience likes. Hashtag tweet tip. How many of you use hashtags in any social media? How many of you know what hashtags are? How many of you find them crazy? Like some people overdo that. Right? Okay. Why do we hashtag? What's... Because you have to. It's a socially acceptable thing to do. Why hashtags?
So if you hashtag a lot of the same thing and people click on that hashtag, they can go to like different stuff.
Yeah. So tweet tip, if I were to click on that, any post that is hashtagged with tweet tip, that sounds weird, is going to show up in one feed. So it's like a collection of all of those things. So, hashtags is a word phrase without spaces beginning with the hashtag. Back in the old day, it was also called the number sign or the pound sign. Not too long ago. people add hashtags to link all the content related to a given topic. Click on a hashtag to go directly to that collection. Hashtags that become popular are called trending topics. So if you go to the Twitter homepage, there's going to be trending topics, so whatever hashtag, autism awareness, if it's autism awareness month, that might be trending in the month of autism awareness. Hashtag, if there's some political thing going on, or prayers for Paris, or something like that, when things happen, those would be trending. And then a mention, which is the @ sign. Is like calling out a person. That is their handle or their name on Twitter. So it's like saying people on @Twitter means it's that literal person. So I could say, hey, @BrendaBachman, what's up today? And that's a way of calling out that exact person. So if you want to like, hey, @Delta, where's my bag? Hashtag losers. Then Delta would see it, and Delta would quickly say, we're very sorry we've lost your bag. Okay, so that's the parts. Now when you look at the actual page, it's a lot like Facebook. It used to not look quite the same, now it very much does. So you have a username, a profile picture, a cover type picture, some information about you, and a pinned tweet. So your Twitter name, the @name, which is that number one username right there, is your unique identifier on Twitter. It can contain up to 15 characters and should help people easily find your business. Your name, which you can change as you please, appears above it. So the if @BrendaBachman is taken and my only option is @BrendaBachman39427 and I don't want to use that, I might use @GoatGirl or something like that, but I can still have my real name above it. Okay? Try to get your Twitter name to be as close to your real business name as possible, because that's what people are expecting, right? If it's not available, try to think of some variations you can to make it be your business name. Your profile photo, choose a photo that represents your business or brand. It's the icon in every tweet you post. So if your logo is identifiable, I would say it's your logo, right? If you're a celebrity or an influencer, it's probably your face. The bio, which is number 3, that's right underneath your username. Oops. You have 160 characters to let people know what makes your account special, why they should follow you. Include useful information such as what you tweet about, your location or business hours, and a link to your website. Use a unique link so you can track visitors from Twitter. What did we learn about a few weeks ago that can make a unique link for you? Someone was assigned that topic when we did all the different topics.
Definitely.
Which one?
Bit.ly.
Yeah, Bit.ly. Bit.ly or any URL shortener. So you could create a landing page or send people to your website, but create a Bit.ly from it that's unique and know that whatever, however many people come to your page from that came straight from the Twitter, your main page on Twitter. So it's a good way to track it. Number 4 is your big picture, your header image. Consider this as a billboard. Use event photos, feature products. Change it out periodically to just keep things fresh. And then the last thing, number 5, which is the very first tweet that sits right here, and it's called a pinned tweet. So I forgot that this one is active. A pinned tweet is always going to be at the top, whereas if you don't have a pinned tweet, it's always the most current to the last post you did, the last tweet. So a pinned tweet is an important tweet that you can keep there by pinning it, and you can get to this in the more option and say pin this to your profile page. This is stuff that you want visitors to always see. It's your biggest, latest news, so if you post 3 times a day but one thing was really critical, you might want to pin it for the day, or you might want to have a permanent pin post. Have you guys ever been on discussion boards? Even in Facebook, where there's a pinned post at the top, it's like the rules of how you use that forum. They don't want to get buried, so they pin it to the very top. Profile picture specifications, again, this is what I have for right now, but it sometimes does change. So last week, I think we looked at different websites that have the most current social media guidelines. Just like Facebook, you can upload something and kind of crop it and shrink it in. But if you were making something specific, here are some recommended numbers. Use a GIF or a PNG file if you have line art. So if you have a logo, use those. If it's a photo, use a JPEG, typically. All right, the value of a follower. What is the value of a follower to a business? When someone follows you on Twitter, they not only are opting in to see your tweets, they're agreeing to see everything you're feeding them. They also take actions that provide value to your business. So you can see how they're behaving, see what they're doing, see what's trending, see maybe what they're complaining about. So in a survey from a couple years ago, followers feel more positively about your business and can help expand your reach and increase sales. So do you want followers? Absolutely. They are agreeing to accept in their inbox, in their app, whatever you send them, which is pretty cool. 78% of people who follow small to medium businesses retweet content from that business. So those of you that are following people, do you find yourself retweeting, or are you just looking and moving on? You're also using it as a personal person, not as a business who's trying to build up goodwill, so that's a little bit different. 75% feel better about a small or medium business after following and reading its tweets. Oh, happy day, they feel better. And 69% have purchased after following them on Twitter. So are these good numbers? Absolutely. Are you ready to build a community of engaged Twitter followers? Yes. So how do we go about doing that? Promote your username everywhere. Add a follow button on your website. Include a link to your Twitter profile in your email signature. Have all your social media at the bottom of your outgoing email signatures. Promote it on your business cards, on your signs. All of you that made sites through Wix or WordPress, there was probably a social media app that was already, not app, like a plugin that was already there that showed all the icons. You just didn't have them yet to link to them, right? So now when you go back before you present next week, go back into your websites and actually hook it up to your fake business account and hook it up to your fake Twitter account that we're going to make today. Make them active. Number two, tap into your existing customer base. Upload your email contacts and let them know you're on Twitter. Say, hey, we're on Twitter, start following us there. Search keywords and hashtags that relate to your industry and audience. Use them to enter into a conversation and get noticed in the first place. Follow influencers. So if there's an influencer in your world, follow them. Retweet what they're saying. Kind of become their friend, and then one day they might retweet you. Has anybody been retweeted by anybody famous in here? Actually, I know people that it's happened. Like, they, yeah. You have?
Yeah.
Yeah. Is like, oh my gosh, I can't believe it just happened.
Oh, I'm not going to find myself.
All right. Bring your offline advocates online. So ask your employees, people that work for you, to follow you and to retweet your content. If you partner with other businesses, arrange to promote each other. So cute stuff and crafty things might be promoting each other and like working together. Your employees should be encouraged to follow you on social media and to retweet and be proud about what you do there. So everybody at the coffee shop ought to be retweeting everything you say. Everybody at your breakfast cafe that works there ought to be proud to retweet and to share on social media. As for retweets, when someone retweets your content, they're sharing your business with their network, which is a whole new group of people in reach. You can order or offer to release an exclusive coupon or something if a tweet reaches a certain number of retweets. So you post something, you say, if this gets retweeted 500 times, you're all entered into a drawing for a free trip to Hawaii, whoever's the travel agent here. You, right? Yeah, that could be an option. Share this great deal. So learn about your Twitter followers. You have to know who your customers are. This is easy, kind of common sense. There's a dashboard on Twitter that helps you. It's called the analytics or the dashboard. You'll be able to see how many people are following you, and if it's growing, you'll be able to see their interests and their demographics, location, gender, things like that. Checking in with your audience as it grows and changes is going to help you create content that stays relative to them. So if all of a sudden you think your main demographic is 40 to 50-year-old homeowners at your landscape company, and you find that all of a sudden 20-year-olds are retweeting everything because they're really into being green and sustainable and this and that, that's a whole new demographic that you might not have realized you had, and you can support them with content as well. You can compare your audience against the average Twitter user, your tailored audiences and significant groups, to see where you stand against the typical Twitter user. And you can do ads on Twitter. So I went to the Twitter ads page. And, of course, there's this whole thing, get started. You have to have an account to get going in. But here's some of the things you can do. You can reach your potential customers and gain more followers, and then you can measure your results. So you're going to choose a targeted audience based on interest, geography, gender, the device that they're using, or anything else. You can maximize the relevancy of your message by using keywords that are going to make them pay attention to it. Then you can amplify your message, which means you can pay to get it shared with even more people pushed. You set a budget, so you only pay when users follow your account or retweet something, and this can be very, very useful. There's a success story of businesses on Twitter that I'm going to show you a little later, and let me jump back to this. The analytics is the dashboard where you can keep track of what's going on. So you can measure engagement and learn how to make your tweets more successful. You can see what your followers are doing, who else they follow. And here's all the information about how you actually get signed up and get going with it once you have an account. So social media used to just be that. Socially hanging out with friends and talking. Now it's very, very, very important for marketing and advertising. You can't ignore it anymore. So if all of your businesses existed in real life, you would have to be on social media and be paying attention to it now. You just can't avoid it. If you do, you're going to lose out. You can track the performance of those ads. So here's the dashboard and the different pieces of it. The first thing at the very top is impressions. That's what number one is way up there. And impressions are how many times your ads have been seen. So when you're on Twitter, how many, or Facebook, think of something that you use, ads are always popping up, right? Does the fact that you see them necessarily mean anything? Are you a customer? Are you a buyer just because you saw it?
No.
No. So how many times your ads have been seen, but that's important to know how much it's getting out. Number two in this dashboard, which is down here towards the bottom, are the results. And the results are whatever objective you set up when you made this campaign. So it might be website visits. If that's what you say your goal is, every time somebody clicks through and follows your website, that counts as score one for you. They actually did what you wanted. Your engagement rate, so that's the number of impressions divided by the number of results. So if you have 1 million people see your ads, but only 2 people click through to go to your website, was that really great? Do you think? Probably not, simple math. But if you have 50 people see your ad pop up and 10 click through, I would think that's pretty good. Because like we said, the ads popping up, sometimes they are extremely targeted. But even if an ad pops up that's 100% up my alley, doesn't mean I'm going to click on it and go see what's going on for a variety of reasons. And then the last part is the cost per result. So how much you're paying for getting people whatever your goal was. So if I said my goal is that they click on my website and go to my website, that's all my goal is. They don't even have to buy. I just want to get them there. And I'm going to give you $10 today. It's going to say what my cost was per click or per result. So you can filter everything. This is a whole business, by the way. People being social media analysts and marketers is a whole industry. If you love this, like you guys in marketing, you can spend nothing but your career doing social media and developing campaigns and tracking them. All right, compelling content. So for you guys, for your small businesses or wherever you may end up working, tweets. Does anybody know how many characters can be in a tweet or used to be?
160
or 140
yeah.
was the normal, and that's all you could have. When you hit that, it would stop typing. So the point about tweets was short, simple, to the point. They started something not too long ago about super users, where they were letting them have 240 characters. I don't know where that is right now, but it's short. So this is why a few things are important. See this weird URL right here? This strange looking thing, that's way better than saying www.cutestuff.com/dresses/spring/blah blah blah to get them to that one page, right? That's a gajillion characters. So this is a lot shorter. Another thing is that the hashtags don't seem to count against you. So you can type your message in your 140 characters and then say hashtag cutestuff, hashtag spring dress, hashtag pink, whatever. You can go crazy with that. So, concise tweet focused on one message. You don't ramble in these. Visuals. Have we not learned by now the power of photos? All of your websites are gorgeous because you guys are using probably the stock photos that came in Wix. Visuals are critical. Add an image, a video, a GIF. Higher engagement rates. 3 times as likely to engage, to stop and look. So Twitter tended to be very much just short little messages if you were going through. Now there's tending to be a lot more visuals added because people will stop and look. You can attach up to 4 photos in a single tweet. So they did this little montage here. Incorporate relevant hashtags. Popular events, personal events, anything that makes sense, but it has to be relevant. All right. Speaking of hashtags.
Hey, Justin, what's up?
Not much, Jimmy. Hashtag chillin'. What's up with you?
It's been busy working. Hashtag rising grind. Hashtag is it Friday yet?
Hey, check it out. I brought you some cookies. Hashtag homemade. Hashtag oatmeal raisin. Hashtag show me the cookie.
Sweet. Hashtag don't mind if I don't. Pretty good. Hashtag get my cookie on. Hashtag I'm the real cookie monster. Hashtag
delicious, right? Hashtag I didn't know I'm for the cookie. Hashtag
By the way, did you catch last week's episode of Duck Dynasty? Hashtag quack quack.
Not lately, I've mostly been watching Netflix. Hashtag orange is the new black.
Oh, nice. I've been watching a lot of Barney the Dinosaur. Hashtag purple is the new black. Hashtag I love you, you love me, we're a happy family. Hashtag I'm 38. Hashtag dinosaurs. Hashtag how do they go extinct? Hashtag meteor. Hashtag ice age. Hashtag speaking of ice age, I just watched ice age on demand the other day. Hashtag funny. Hashtag Ray Romano. Hashtag Deborah. Hey, by the way. Halloween's only like a month away.
I
mean, do you know where you're gonna be at? Hashtag life decisions, hashtag sexy ghost.
I think I'm gonna go as a ninja turtle. Hashtag gotta be Raphael. Hashtag Leonardo sucks. Hashtag the turtle, not the Italian Renaissance painter. Hashtag Mona Lisa. Hashtag is she smiling? Hashtag speaking of smiling, I just saw my dentist. Hashtag bling. Hashtag dental care. Hashtag cavity free. Hashtag that's how we do. Hashtag we go hard. Hashtag we can't stop.
We won't stop.
Hashtag we run this.
Hashtag two players for life.
Hashtag is it worth it or let me work it.
Hashtag put my thing down, flip it, then reverse it.
Hashtag
it's your permission to look at it.
Hashtag
it's your permission to look at it.
Hey guys.
Yeah, Quest?
What's up?
Hashtag shut the f*** up.
Hashtags.
In case you didn't know what they were, now you do.
All right. Other ways to engage your customers or your followers, not customers. Ask questions and run polls. For some reason, people love a poll. Even if you have no skin in the game, you want to click on it and vote, right? You could care less, but you got to get involved. But if you have real questions about your business or you kind of want to see where people are, why not run a poll or some sort of ask a question, open-ended question. Then you get actual dialogue back and forth. Curate, which means collect, and retweet other people's comments and replies. So, let's see, the dashboard, the tweet dashboard, we kind of looked at this already, but you can see on this dashboard all the different things that are going out. So, quickly gauge your month-to-month performance. You can export it as a .csv file. So, admins especially, you guys know that one, right? Comma separated values. Is that what the V is? So, it's an Excel file, right, that you can export and bring in. So, you could, look at the numbers in a different way. There are insights on every tweet that you post. And click on individual tweets in this dashboard to pull up even more specifics, like how many people viewed the video, how many people clicked on the photo, how many people retweeted or replied. All right. Twitter success stories. This is right from their site as well. And it just shows a bunch of different companies that have used Twitter and how they used it, what their success story was. So if you are thinking about using this for your business in the real world, or a business that you end up working for, it might be worth your time to look at a couple of these success stories and see how other companies use Twitter. Oops. And that's that part. Where's Google? I'm just going to show you a few minutes of this video on YouTube, how to use Twitter for business, because it also talks about LinkedIn a little bit. How many of you are on LinkedIn? How many of you should be on LinkedIn? Everybody, hands in the air, wave them around, because that's your professional version of Facebook. That's where you portray what your skill set is, where you work, where you want to work. You network with people in the industry that you want to be in. That's the professional side of Facebook. So for a business to be on, it's a networking, the professional version of Facebook. So businesses should also have a presence on LinkedIn, especially businesses that are B2B businesses that sell to other businesses. That's a huge, huge marketing place for that. So in this video, he's going to talk a little bit about why Twitter and how you can use it for business right now.
Know how to use Twitter as a lead generation magnet?
watch this video. What's going on, everyone? Carlos Gill here, also known as @CarlosGill83 on Twitter. Now, let's jump right into it. A lot of folks out there, when they meet me, assume that my favorite social network is Instagram or Facebook or back in the day, Snapchat. What they don't know is that Twitter is the OG gangster of social media. I've had a Twitter account since April of 2009, and back in the day during the recession, when I was growing a tiny startup in Jobs Direct USA, I was successfully able to use Twitter to do a lot of what I'm going to share with you in this video here today, which is really how to grow a following and a business with zero budget. The first step is you have to use Twitter as a search engine. If anything else, if you never post a single tweet, you can still use Twitter as a search engine. In fact, no different than Google or YouTube, you can go on Twitter right now and you can type in specific search phrases to find people speaking about similar interests or topics, or to go ahead and see who's interested in your services. I work a lot with real estate agents, and I encourage real estate agents to go on Twitter every single day and literally run a search for moving to your city, relocating to your city, looking for a home in your city. That's how easy it is to use Twitter as a search engine to find leads. Once again, you don't have to be an active content creator on Twitter. You don't have to participate in Twitter chats. You never have to send a single tweet to get the value out of Twitter. As crazy as that sounds, just use Twitter as a search engine. The other thing that you want to do is use Twitter to see what's being said about your competition and about your industry. Social media, my friends, is the wild, wild west. And no one ever talks about this, but you can use Twitter right now in real time to see what's being said about your competitors. And guess what? If someone's having a bad experience with who your competition is, that is a prime opportunity for you to swoop in and go ahead and form a relationship with that new customer of yours who used to be a customer or a follower or a supporter of your competition. How do you use LinkedIn and Twitter together? Well, I consider LinkedIn and Twitter to be the perfect marriage. In fact, back in the day when I was growing my business, I would go on LinkedIn, I would research on LinkedIn who it is that I want to do business with and learn all about their professional background. And then guess what I would do? I'd go over to Twitter and I would look up their name to see if they had a Twitter account, or I'd go on Google and type in their name plus Twitter. And if they were on Twitter, I would go ahead and connect with them there. That is no different than what I recommend to anyone today that's using LinkedIn to sell. Most of the networking and sales doesn't happen on LinkedIn. However, LinkedIn is an extremely valuable database to find business professionals. So what you want to do is go on LinkedIn search, use LinkedIn to search executives or find executives at companies that you want to do business with. That's as simple as literally go on LinkedIn search, type in the name of the company that you want to do business with, and start looking at who your executive team is, and then go over to Google or go over to Twitter, find those individuals, now that you know who are the decision makers at these organizations, and then just start having a conversation with them. It's literally mind-blowing how easy this is, but it is a step that is commonly overlooked. I speak to so many professionals that make money and they're good at what they do, and I'll ask them, are you on Twitter? And they'll always say to me, like, no, I need to get on it. Is there any value in Twitter? Oh, I don't get it. It's so complicated. Once again, people, it's a search engine. So there's a little degree of social stalking that goes into sales online. And if you're using LinkedIn already, you should be on Twitter, and you should be really using both of them to, once again, identify on LinkedIn who you want to do business with, and then start having conversations with them over on Twitter. Now,
you guys see any value in that?
Yes.
Could you see value in it in your personal life right now? Outside of this class? How? Anybody looking for a job anytime soon?
Oh, that's me.
Looking for a company you want to work with, maybe? Stalk them, social stalking. Yeah. Go on LinkedIn, research everything you can about them. See if they have a Twitter handle. See who their decision makers are, their big dogs. And then, because anybody can follow anybody on Twitter, you don't have to be friends. I mean, if the grand poobah of the greatest company on earth has a Twitter and you are engaging in conversation with them, maybe you're one of 3 million and they don't know you, but think of smaller companies or local companies and you're always posting and engaging. You're going to stand out. So think about this from your own personal job search or researching cool places to work. When you guys go into interviews, you have to know about the company. You can't sit down and say, tell me about your company. You need to have done that beforehand and be able to tell them, I love how your company does this. It's so cool that you're doing this. I love that you're on social media. I follow you guys all the time. Think about how you can use this in the real world, not just in your fake business today also.
I know what you're probably thinking, what am I going to have conversations with these individuals about? And it's simple. Whatever they're talking about in the moment, go with the flow. With Twitter, you don't need permission to hop into a conversation. That's what I love about the platform. You don't have to be friends like you are on Facebook. You don't have to be in a private mastermind group or anything like that. If someone tweets something out on Twitter, it is open game for you to just swoop in like a hawk and start having conversations openly. The next tip is a super gangster tip. Are you ready for it? Use Twitter to look up conference hashtags. Now, hear me out. It is logistically impossible and also very expensive to get to every industry conference. However, with social media and an iPhone, you can participate in discussions happening at a conference in real time as if you were even there. The beauty of it is you can form new relationships with people that are at an industry conference without ever having to travel. So it's really simple. You know the industry conferences in the field that you work in probably better than I. Start creating an Excel spreadsheet of when these conferences are happening and what the hashtag is. And then create hashtag searches, which you save right onto your phone or your desktop computer, so you can start monitoring the conversations happening and who is starting these conversations. And then once the conference actually takes place, start jumping into the conversations. Like I said before in the last tip, it's open territory. It's the wild, wild west of social media. So what's going to happen is as you're getting involved in these conversations around industry conferences, there's going to be a perception of, wow, maybe this person is here. I should connect with them too. They're important. They're in my space. What you want to do is you want to get to the executives that are networking online, on Twitter specifically, at these conferences. So here's often what happens. Someone will be on stage, and they'll be like a chief marketing officer for a brand. And a bunch of people start tweeting them out, and they're tagging the person along the conference hashtag. This is great. You want this. So what you're going to do is, as soon as that person gets off the stage, and now the social media feed starts to die down because they've already spoken and the next person's on, what you want to do is you want to then swoop in and say, like, hey, Matt, or hey, Jill, that was a great talk. I really enjoyed it. Kudos. I'd love to connect on LinkedIn. Is that okay? What you want to do is get on this person's radar. The good thing is you already know they exist. Now you're on their radar. You're engaging in the conference discussion. And hopefully what they do is they acknowledge you back. And then you connect on LinkedIn and you can tell them how amazing you are. So this is where I go back to LinkedIn. Remember like I said before, there's a marriage between LinkedIn and Twitter. You really can't use one without the other. So the key is when you follow back up on LinkedIn. You want to connect with this individual that spoke at the conference, that you rode the wave of the conference hashtag, and then you want to remind them in your introductory email or connection request to them. Follow up from Twitter and put the conference hashtag. Once again, there's going to be a perception that you were at the conference. You never have to mention that you weren't at the conference. You followed along the conference hashtag and you saw they had a good talk. So you, in essence, attended virtually. But you never have to disclose that you weren't there. You can continue riding that momentum wave. Hey, once again, it's great to connect with you over here on LinkedIn. We connected on Twitter. You had a great talk at XYZ conference. I'd love to stay in touch. Boom! Do that at every single industry trade show. I guarantee you, if you're watching this video now and you do this over the next year, you're going to come back to me and you're going to say, thank you so much. This, Carlos, made a huge impact to my bottom line. And guess what? If you don't do it, you're missing out. The last tip, my friends, is a controversial one, so I want to save it to the end, and it's called list jacking. What is list jacking? It's very simple. If you go to most
industry trade publications, like for example, Entrepreneur on Twitter, and you go to their profile and you see what lists they are added to, you're gonna see lists that have already been curated with thought leaders, with media, with brands. Once again, if you're looking to sell, then you're gonna wanna look at the list for trade organizations that executives at companies. This is a super easy way for you to cut through the clutter. So when you list check, you start going publication by publication, you start seeing what lists they're added to, and then you can also see people that have been added to these lists, provided they're executives and also decision makers of the companies that they work. Now you have like a legit prospect list that you can do everything I've just mentioned in this video, which is connect, engage, go to LinkedIn, message them, go stalk them online. Like, not literally, but go see what they're posting and where, and more importantly, go have a conversation with them. All right, that is it.
He talks fast, doesn't he?
Time is money.
Oh, okay. Here we go. All right. So, again, this can be a whole career. People can spend all their time on social media marketing. So I know that this is a admin class and a marketing class, but from the standpoint of web technologies that you can use for your small business and you may end up using, Twitter is important. Okay? Twitter is important. LinkedIn is important. Facebook is important. All the 20 that we went through last week or 2 weeks ago, we decided that some fit in depending on your target market, right? Snapchat is going to work for some of you. Instagram is going to work for some of you. Not for everybody, definitely. So you have to really think about your demographic and who you're going for. All right. All right, Twitter jargon, we talked about that. So what we're going to be doing, I want you to brainstorm a variety of tweets to cover three different aspects. So tweets that you would share kind of follow that same, well, not the same, a rule on social media where you're not selling, or people are going to get annoyed and stop following you, right? If all you do is talk about, you know, buy this now, people are going to get sick and tired and they're going to unfollow you on any social media. So the rule of thumb is that you kind of do four pieces of happy, helpful, educational, entertainment value, and then you do a piece of sales and a piece of promotion or company info. So sales and marketing, so promoting something on Twitter, company information, telling about your company, and then general information could be more about your industry. So what I need you to do for your homework, whether you do it right now or next week, is you need to make two sample tweets for your company for each of these categories. So two sales tweets, two tweets just talking about your company, and two general information, whether that's about your industry, things that people that follow you might like, maybe a holiday, something like that. So six tweets total, and they're going to go in the Dropbox because I'm not going to see your Twitter page until you show it next week in class during your presentation. So we obviously need to set up a Twitter page, and that is what we're going to do after the break. So I want you to add these tweets also to your Twitter page once we get it set up, but instead of me going there and looking, you're just going to copy and paste them into like a Word document and submit them in Blackboard also. Okay? So let's stop here for a break, and when we come back, we'll actually get a Twitter page for your business built.